What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of Sammy's Place. I am Sam A. Today we're going to get into a few unreleased albums altogether. Reason why for putting them together like this is because there's not much to say about them other than just really mentioning them. I don't even have some producers in mind or any type of information whatsoever, so maybe you guys will know. Let me know if you do. The first one we're going to get into is Jenny's Ring. I believe that's how you say it. Jene, some shit like that. Anyways, she was supposed to put out an album in 2002. It was August 2002. Never happened. She had the lead single, Get Into Something. Now it's time to get into something. She was signed with Motown. There was also a remix to Get Into Something that featured Lady May and Foxy Brown. It's now your ex, you have some self-respect. Next you got your check. Now it's time to get into something. It was produced by Mayro Winans. I think it even had P. Diddy on there, if I'm not mistaken. No video. The only one that actually had a video was the Get Into Something, the original version. Fun video, just went nowhere. Then just maybe about a year or so ago, Stewart from Beats for the Streets told me that she kind of said some racial shit towards one of the O-Town members on a show.
And Jen comes running in the kitchen behind me and starts yelling about Eric and cursing out Eric. And I looked behind to see what was going on and heard that she called Eric spick. And I turned around to look at her to see if she was joking or not. And she just stormed off.
I don't appreciate you saying what you did about him.
We were all... Okay, well, he said nasty things also.
I wasn't there to hear that. I was there to hear you call him. And that's not right.
Okay, we're all joking around. In there. And of course, yes, when you're angry, you say things that are stupid. And that's what I did.
Okay, so apologize to him.
You want me to apologize to him?
Mm-hmm.
For saying that?
He'll know that you said that.
But I don't care.
All right, then if you don't care that he knows you said that, then he's probably going to want you to leave.
And I don't know if that had anything to do with the lack of impact her single made. I had no idea of that, by the way, back then. I had no idea who she was. I thought she was just this new girl. Her song, Sometimes It Hurts, was later on given to Kylie Dean. Now, I don't know if that was for the Changes era or if that was for the reworked version of Simple Girl, which is the direction of, like, Who Will I Run To? Would kind of make sense, though. Yeah, other than that, there's not much else to say about this album. There was a second single called Phenomenal Woman that featured Loon. That could have maybe possibly done well had it just been given the push it needed, like a video to start with. Altogether, the album itself is a nice listen. The songs are very poppy, very like dated, even for its time of, well, it was scheduled release. It sounded a little bit too dated for where pop was going at the time. But then there were those certain tracks that had a more of a urban vibe, and I feel like those, if they would have given me more of those, well, then again, the album didn't even get released, so it doesn't really fucking matter. Anyways, yeah, so there's not much else to say about her. She didn't do anything else musically. You can Google her. She ventured off into something completely like out of entertainment, music, and all that stuff. It was nothing to do with that at all. Don't know why she gave that up. Maybe it has to do with the racial shit she said. Who knows? Anyways, the second one I'm going to get into is Lovher. It's this way I'm living. Who am I to tell him that what he's doing just ain't right? Standing on the corner, hustling all day, gambling under the streetlight. R&B group that was signed with Death Soul. They released a single in 2002, How It's Gonna Be. Cisco put them together, if I'm not mistaken. They were also featured on his album, the Rush Hour soundtrack, as well as Drew Hill. I was looking forward to these girls. I saw the promo was there. The video was all over BET. It played a lot. So I was quite surprised that the album didn't get released. Maybe a few years later, I finally got the bootleg. It's a nice listen. It was a well-done album. Very 2002. I know they continue to work on music a couple years later. It was a song called Feeling It. I loved that song, yo. I played it a lot. I don't know if that was like new or like something unreleased, or I don't know what the fuck, but it came out a few years, like in 2006 is when I heard it. On my legs, grab your cup, fill them up, no, baby, sit and go on, get your drink on, get up, get your freak on, get up, slide your mink on, get up, I got the ill, lean back, mama, what up? So I'm thinking that was new then, and then that was the last I heard of them. Never again. So if you guys know what happened with them, please tell me. I've been curious for years as to what went wrong here. It kind of reminded me of like TG4. They had a fucking single, Virginity. And this was Seven Streeter's first girl group before she got into like Rich Girl and shit. So they were signed with Chris Stokes. They were supposed to be like a girl version of B2K. Apparently they even had a second single called 2 Minutes. One of the group members left and they even put out another single. It went absolutely nowhere. So I don't know if some bullshit went on behind. Like, you know, when Chris Stokes is involved, it's always some fucking type of shit. But maybe it's just that they couldn't really land another hit. I don't know. But the song Virginity, like, I thought it was doing well. It was constantly played, so, and I liked it. I enjoyed it for what it was. And then there was also that girl group, Isyss, and I didn't even know they put out a fucking album. It was released September 2002. They had this single that featured Jadakiss, Day and Night. That was such a good song, such a sick video too. The second single for the rest of my life, had like a little dance break of fuck, what's the song? It's from The Wash. Can't find that video anywhere. But apparently they recorded a second album, but then they got dropped, so the second album was never released. And then they tried to stay together, but I guess they just couldn't, so they parted ways. And that's all I really know about them. Other than that, I don't know any type of drama or whatever happened between the group, just that they separated. But all these albums were good. There was nothing bad about them. I would have to say the best one out of them was Jene. And that's not to say that either of them are bad. It's just I think I favored more of Jene's album, Jene's Ring. This would suck if I'm saying her name wrong. Also, before I sign off, there's Mario as well as celebrating his 20th anniversary to his debut album when he first stepped on the scene with Just a Friend. I learned the choreography to that video. Yo, I love that video and I love that song. Mario is one of those fresh artists, especially given that at that time he was young, you know, but he wasn't marketed as like a young artist, performer, like, I don't know if you get what I mean. His music was pretty grown. So like anybody at any age could listen to this. Even to this day, you play Just a Friend, you can play it. It's not dated. It's not, it aged very well. But yeah, this album, I didn't really care for it, to be honest. Let Me Love You obviously took things to a whole another level. But Go is my favorite album from Mario, for sure.